Good afternoon and welcome to the first webinar of Invest in Tuscany. My name is Filippo Giabbani and I am the Executive Director of Invest in Tuscany. Today I'm here with Marco Mazzieschi, a Tuscan lawyer specialized in corporate immigration, commercial law and citizenship law.
Thank you, Dr. Giabbani, and thank you to all participants today. We have a long list of participants from all over the world and this confirmed the interest on Tuscany.
This webinar has therefore the objective of informing you about the business opportunities Tuscany can offer and the best visa options available for investors. But let's start with a brief introduction to Tuscany. We're talking about a small Italian region, which is, however, bigger than some European states like Albania, Slovenia or Lithuania. Tuscany is a region internationally renowned for its cultural and touristic offer, but has a very strong and successful tradition in manufacturing, R&D and innovation. And thanks to these strengths, the region was able to attract almost 500 multinational companies, including big brands like GE, GSK, Continental and Celine. As I mentioned before, the manufacturing sector offers great opportunities for foreign investors, both in terms of M&A operations or the setup of a new company. The key sectors belong either to the traditional made in Italy sectors like fashion industry, yacht building and agribusiness, or high-tech industries like ICT and life sciences. There are currently great opportunities also for real estate investors. Indeed, the Tuscan regional government has recently decided to sell its most prestigious assets with a value estimated at 200 million euros. Invest in Tuscany, the specialized office of the regional government, can help you in identifying and achieving the best opportunities, both in the industrial and in the real estate sector. We can assist you in planning the investment, but we can also facilitate the setting up of your presence in the region. I'd like also to underline the great opportunity given to investors by the new incentives recently introduced by the Italian government. I'm talking about the patent box regime, the R&D tax scheme, tax credit and the so-called Industry 4.0 incentive scheme. After this brief introduction, we will start the second part of the webinar, and in this second part we will present some case studies of recent investments in Tuscany along with the most useful visas for international investors. Let's start with joint ventures and merger and acquisition. With a practical example, in 2015, the Japanese company Toray, a leading manufacturer in carbon fiber, acquired the majority of DeltaTech, a small enterprise based in Lucca.
How can a company which acquires an M&A transaction in Tuscany obtain the visa for the workers who are going to be assigned from abroad? The Italian system is generally quite strict because there's quota limitation for the issuance of work permit and visas. But there is a specific exception for intra-company assignments, which extend also to joint venture transactions. In this case, no quota limitation are set forth, so no number is limited. And the issuance of the work permit and visa is relatively easy. It can be done once the two companies are affiliated, so the proof of affiliation is a very important factor, as well as the signing of a joint venture agreement. And it extends, it includes only highly skilled workers. In this case, the online application must be filed by the Italian host company with the submission of all necessary ancillary documents. And after a few weeks, the immigration office will issue the work permit and the worker can go and apply for the visa at the Italian consulate abroad. It's also important to mention that for companies who are intending to send a certain number of employees, the Italian government has in place a specific fast-track procedure. Fast-track procedure is for companies which are firstly validated by the Ministry of Interior and obtaining they sign a protocol agreement with the ministry, and after obtaining this validation, the submission of the online application is not accompanied, is not required to submit any documents. And the work permit is issued with just checking the security, just doing the security checks on the workers. So in a really short, in a few weeks, the workers can obtain their visas, enter Italy, and only at that stage the documents will be necessary. And the workers will go to the immigration office, do the necessary registration, and after that they can immediately start working. So this is an incentive for foreign companies who do establish their entities or do transaction in Tuscany for sending their workers, for facilitating them to send their workers in Italy without any delays.
Another example, in this case, is a case of a setting up of a NewCo. In 2016, the Dutch group, the Student Hotel, decided to enter the Italian market starting from Florence. It acquired an historical building in order to create the first hybrid hotel long-term residence for students in Italy. The hotel will be open in September.
Differently from intra-company assignment, some companies can be interested to localize their foreign workers. It means to hire them directly in Italy. We did not mention that for the intra-company, from the previous case, the workers must remain hired abroad by the sending company. But there are opportunities also and facilitation also for hiring them in Italy directly. This is following a directive, a European directive, which goal was to attract brains, highly skilled workers in Europe. Italy implemented a directive in 2012 and it's called Blue Card Permit. Blue Card Permits apply only to highly skilled workers. And what does it mean, highly skilled workers? Under Italian law, highly skilled is a worker who is offered a minimum one-year contract, a salary not less of €25,000 per year, and he must have at least a 3-year university diploma. If the workers who meet these requirements can be hired, can become Italian employees, and the procedure is similar to the one of the intercompany. The documents to be submitted are different, but still the Italian employer must file an online application, submit all the documents to the immigration office, and after the work permit is approved, the worker can go to the consulate, obtain the visa, enter Italy, and will be registered with the immigration office, and can immediately start working for the company. This scheme has been quite successful in Italy. It's not well known, but is applied differently by various immigration offices, and the European Union is currently studying an implementation of the directive in order to attract even more foreign highly skilled workers. This scheme applies also to highly skilled, for example, to students who obtain a validation and a diploma in Italy. So, in any way, the Italian government is trying to not only to attract, but to stabilize people who studied in Italy, obtained their diplomas in Italy.
Okay, we talked about joint venture, merger and acquisition, setting up a new co. But Tuscany can offer great opportunities also for investing in existing startups. Here's the case. Air Endoscopy, a spin-off of the Sant'Anna School of Advanced Studies in Pisa, developed a new technique for colonoscopy based on a brand new type of robotic device. The revolutionary innovation was particularly appreciated by a Japanese company called Otsuka Medical Devices, which decided to acquire about 25% of the shares.
The startup is a very interesting area because Italy a few years ago approved a specific startup visa. The startup visa is a visa whose goal is to attract startups with innovative ideas and projects. And this visa can be applied in two fields. One is given for those who join, who invest in an existing startup, and the other field is for those who want to start up, to set up their own startup. The requirements are different. In both cases, the main requirement is the innovative idea, innovative project. Often we receive queries where people say, what about if I invest a certain amount of money? But the main goal of the program, of the national program, the startup program, is that the people have to have an innovative idea, an innovative project that they want to develop in Italy. For existing startup, the requirements have been recently changed by the Ministry of Economic Development. Whoever wants to join an existing startup must invest at least 100,000 euro, must be still submit a project, why, what kind of benefit it can will bring to the startup. The startup must be at least 3 years old, and it must be a startup qualified by the ministry, that means falling within the startup Italian program. There are specific characteristics. In this case, the investor will obtain a self-employed visa after the ministry has approved the program, and will enter Italy and will become a shareholder and must be appointed as member of the board. Another possibility for entrepreneurs, simple entrepreneurs, who must show the availability of 50,000 euro in their bank account. There's the investment in the startup must be done after the approval of the visa. And again, the focus here is to submit to the Ministry of Economic Development a project which must be innovative, a new idea how to develop patents, a new kind of market, an innovative strategy. So that's the key factor to obtain the visa. Once the visa is issued, the applicant will enter Italy and will start its business. And in order to get the extension of the permit within 1 year, must prove to have started its company and to start its business. The law does not require any specific economic thresholds. It doesn't have to show a specific turnover or a number of employees to be hired over a certain year. But the project which has been submitted to the ministry must be developed.
So there are great opportunities also for establishing a new startups, because the economic ecosystem in Tuscany is structured in a very positive way for new startups. For example, we have an incubator, the Siena Bio Incubator, which is considered one of the best 15 bio incubators in Europe. But there are also other opportunities of investing in Tuscany, especially, as I mentioned before, in the real estate sector. We talked about the prestigious assets on sale by the regional government of Tuscany. These prestigious assets, located in cities like Florence, Pisa, or Siena, can be transformed in luxury touristic properties or luxury apartments.
What kind of visa can we obtain with someone who invests in a real estate? We often receive this query at our firm. And people think that it is mandatory to buy a house. Actually, the law does not require the people to buy a property. The main requirement for the elective residence visa is to being able to show a substantial and stable income which is not deriving from work sources. Does not need to be a salary, cannot be a salary. Must be an income deriving from investment, from real estate, from annuities, from pensions, retirement funds. And certainly, what is helpful if someone is investing in Tuscany, in Italy, and buying a property, the fact that he has purchased property is a factor that is investing money in the economy, and there's enough money for living in Italy. But again, this is not a mandatory requirement by the law. And we are often asked, what is the minimum value which the house or the property must have? Again, the law does not set any specific threshold. This is the consulate discretion to decide whether or not the flat must have a certain value. And according to our experience, an investment of at least 500,000 euro is important, is necessary. But again, this must be seen in conjunction and together with a proof of the applicant's income. From some countries, we see wealthy people who are not able to satisfactorily prove to the consulate with satisfactory documents, with grounded documents, the income they have. Because it's originated from sources which are not taxable in the country of origin. So this must be a key factor is being able to prove a stable and substantial income.
This information ends the webinar in itself, but now we are at your disposal for answering questions or doubts or curiosities that you have.
Yeah, I'd like to add that Italy has approved in December a new kind of visa, which is the investor visa. This visa is not operative yet. It will most likely enter into full force in October, according to the information that we have from the Ministry of Economic Development. The investor visa is a pure, different from the elective resident visa, is purely based on investment. And the law so far has identified different kind of investments. So whoever will invest 2 million euro in government bonds, or will invest 1 million euro in an Italian company, or 1 million euro in a charity or a philanthropic project, or 500,000 in a startup duly qualified by the law, will be able to get this visa. The procedure is most likely to be an application filed with the Ministry of Economic Development, which will evaluate the investment and will grant permission for the issuance of visa. But again, everything is on the air so far, and we expect to have the decree for the implementation of the new law by October. So we will keep you posted, and if you have a look at the Investing Tuscany website, you will be constantly up to date.
Okay, it's time for Q&A, if we have.
Yeah, we have some questions. Is how long does it take to get a standard work permit? It's very important to evaluate the financial stability of the company. So in case of an acquisition, for example, of an existing company, the procedure is relatively easy, should be straightforward, because the immigration office will easily assess that the companies are existing, are operating, are on business. It can be more difficult in case of a newly established company or a newly established entity. A branch doesn't have a capital. The newly established company very often is started with a capital of minimum capital of 10,000 euro, and this can be difficult for the immigration office to assess whether a company has the financial stability. So in some cases we have to provide the financials of the parent company, or we require clients to fund the company with a higher capital, so that to be able to prove that there are enough funds for starting the operations. Another question is about, do I need to purchase a house to get the elective resident visa? No. As I mentioned before, this is some misleading information on the web. This is not a requirement. So you can rent a flat, for example, and because again, the consulate will focus on other factors. You need to prove to have a suitable accommodation. This is important. But the key aspect for the consulate to decide upon the issuance of the visa is being able to prove that your income, and income are not the money that you have in your bank account, are the money that are generated from your funds or other investments. That's the key factor that will be taken into account by the ministry. And the last question, what is the difference between the two kind of startup visa, joining a startup or invest in a new startup? As mentioned by Dr. Giabbani, there are incubators in Tuscany, all over Italy, several incubators in Tuscany. Incubators are companies which are managing new startups. So when an investor interested to join an existing startup must identify, and very often this is done through the help of an incubator, a startup who is needs funds, but needs the implementation, needs someone to bring in new ideas, new access to a new market. We have had recently some startup visas for investors from China who were contribution. We are bringing to startups is the access to a new market, to the Chinese market, for example. In this case, it's important the investment of 100,000 euro. This is required by the ministry. But the key aspect for getting the approval and the visa will not be the money, will be what kind of contribution the individual will bring to the startup. That's the key aspect that will be evaluated. Why? To start your own startup, again, if you have a new idea, and Investing Tuscany can help. to identify the location, to identify a possible partner, for example. You need to show that you have 50,000 euro available only, and again, focus on the kind of project that you want to develop in Tuscany. But if you have a valuable project, a sustainable project, you can be sure that you can find in Invest in Tuscany and in the business environment, the technological environment you have in Siena, you have in Florence, there are many hubs in Pisa that there are in Tuscany, which are high-end areas where you can find partners and the good environment to invest. Thank you. I think that if we any other questions that you can use the platform of Invest in Tuscany, and we are happy
to disposal. And available. Yeah, absolutely. I'd like to thank Mr. Mazzeschi for the precious and very practical information he gave us, and all the participants for the time and attention. And we hope to meet you again at the next live session, the next webinar, and we will be informed about it. Thank you.
Thank you.